The following is a broadcast of the Majority Rule Day Church Service held at St. Francis Xavier Cathedral, January 10, 2018.
Beloved in Christ, it's my pleasure to welcome you to our Cathedral Church to celebrate this ecumenical service in commemoration of Majority Rule Day. My name is Father Kendrick Forbes. I am the Vicar General for the Archdiocese of Nassau. Please follow along in your booklet for the order of service, and we will begin with the call to worship by Bishop Ross Davis.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. O Lord, thou art my God. I will exalt thee. I will praise thy name, for thou hast done wonderful things. Thy counsels, O, are faithfulness and truth. O, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him spirit and in truth. And ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water. And I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Somewhere. Testament reading is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 30, commencing at the 18th verse. Yet the Lord longs to be gracious to you. Therefore, he will rise up to show you compassion. For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are all who wait for him. People of Zion, who live in Jerusalem, you will weep no more. How gracious he will be when you cry for help. As soon as he hears, he will answer you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The purpose for our being here today is to give God thanks and praise. We do so because this powerful God, in his divine wisdom, love, and compassion for humanity and the nations of the world, had and still do the Bahamas in his plan. He had us as a people, at the time of colony, move to a change which was revolutionary and quiet, bringing these islands to a place that he, God, had designed for it. He did this through his guidance, provision, protection, and direction. His sovereign hand brought us to commemorate Majority Rule Day, which was declared a public holiday in 2014. Majority rule was achieved in 1967, when the January 10th general election outcome reflected that blacks got faith in themselves and in God to govern their country. This happened because God said it was time. Along with emancipation from slavery in 1836 and gaining independence in 1973, the achievement of majority rule is considered one of the most important accomplishments in the history of the Bahamas. It symbolizes the promise of equality and a level playing field for all Bahamians, black and white. It ushered in the opportunity for all Bahamians to have constitutional, political, social, cultural, and economic rights. Where these rights were not accessible in 1967, the then government, the Progressive Liberal Party, began the transformation, creating laws and implementing policies to enable entitlements for all. There have been much accomplishments, as blacks have been able to aspire to many offices in the land and become part of an institution such as banks, theaters, lodges, churches, and so forth. They can purchase land and become homeowners in areas where they were not able to do so prior to January 10th. The governments, the Progressive Liberal Party, and the Free National Movement have done much over 5 decades, but there is still much to do. As we look down the corridors of history, we see the road to majority rule marked by some very sobering events. These include the Burma Road riots, the suffrage movement in the Bahamas, the general strike, the formation of the Progressive Liberal Party, women's right to vote, and Black Tuesday. Those who would have participated in those events
reading from the book of the prophet Micah. What can we bring to the Lord? Should we bring him burnt offerings? Should we bow before God Most High with offerings of yearling calves? Should we offer him thousands of rams and 10,000 rivers of olive oil? Should we sacrifice our firstborn children to pay for our sins? No. O people, the Lord has told you what is good, and this is what he requires of you, to do what is right, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God. Fear the Lord if you are wise. His voice calls to everyone in Jerusalem. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel reading comes from St. Luke, chapter 4. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he had anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He had sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised." And he closed the book, and gave it again to the minister, and sat down. The Gospel of the Lord Jesus.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My friends, I welcome you all to our Cathedral Church of St. Francis Xavier. I greet you in the name of Archbishop Pinder, who is presently in Trinidad, where he's attending a meeting for the bishops of our conference. I also greet you on behalf of the Rector of Cathedral, Father Glenn Nixon, and on behalf of the entire Catholic Archdiocese of Nassau. A warm welcome to all of you. One of the noble traits of our Bahamian people is that we set aside time for religious observance for events of national significance, national importance. Today, we gather in this cathedral church to commemorate one of the defining moments in our nation's history, a day in a series of events that would shape our nation's history and chart a course for the future. On this majority rule day, we celebrate that value which lies at the heart of a truly independent people, namely democracy, the right and responsibility to determine how we would govern ourselves, the right to choose who will administer our national affairs, and yes, who will govern us. The former Governor General of the Bahamas, Sir Arthur Folks, summed up what we observe today rather succinctly in his message on this day in 1994. Sir Arthur wrote, "Majority rule day shattered false notions of superiority or inferiority. It initiated the fulfillment of the promise of universal access to education. It created the foundation upon which to build a society with opportunity for all. It unleashed the powerful entrepreneurial instincts of a people. It freed many Bahamians from the fear of one another because of differences of color or ethnic origin. It opened the possibility of fully sharing and nationalizing a rich and diverse cultural heritage. And it held forth the promise of a new kind of political culture in which no Bahamian would ever again be made to suffer for exercising his or her right to free association." My friends, what we observe on this day belongs to all, regardless of our political affiliations or our ethnicity. Majority rule is about democracy. It's about the fundamental dignity of every human being, a dignity which says that all peoples, women, men, and children, rich and poor, black and white, all should have equal access to education, to health care, to employment, among others. The struggle for majority rule was for our own freedom, the chance to shape our own destiny, to govern ourselves, to cultivate a national vision, to articulate the freedoms we would hold as fundamental, foundational to our identity as a people. And so the question to contemplate as we gather here today is this: have we cultivated that national vision? How have we advanced the principles that propelled what we observe today? My friends, it's important for Bahamians, my generation and younger, not to hastily dismiss what we observe today, because what we observe today calls us to offer ourselves in the offer of something greater than self-interest. We are living at a time when so many people are hurting, when so many people are in need, when the pressure simply to survive is increasing. It's through service that we assist in making a reality those powerful words inscribed on our nation's coat of arms: forward, onward,
upward together. The future of our nation, our family of islands, summons us to preserve and protect, to foster and cultivate peace, to defend the value of life and to affirm the dignity of all peoples. All of us, no matter who we are, no matter our social standing, no matter our age, all are summoned to this task. As we gather here today, we celebrate the sacred gift of freedom. And freedom places squarely on our shoulders tremendous responsibility. We hear echoes of this in the readings chosen for this service, particularly the passage from the prophet Micah. The prophet Micah was an unexpected prophet. He was an insignificant peasant from the lowlands southwest of Jerusalem. And although he lived through a series of intense crises, including the destruction of the northern kingdom of Israel, the invasion of Judah by the Assyrians, Micah focused his message on social injustice. Like all of the prophets, Micah lamented the corruption that had taken root among the people. And like the prophet Amos, he saw that the heart of the law, going all the way back to the book of Exodus, came down to compassion, how we treat each other. Listen again to what Micah says. What does the Lord require of you? To do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. What the prophet expresses is more than a catchy slogan, more than a nice tweet. In our common usage, the word justice means fairness, fair play, people getting their due, equity within the human family. But in the Old Testament, justice was particularly social in nature. Justice was about striving to ensure that people were not deprived of the basic necessities of life, that which is necessary to function as part of the community. Are we living up to the demands of justice? Do we look at people who are not treated as equals and advocate for them? Do we speak up when we hear someone use words that demean others? Micah mentions kindness. And this word is sometimes translated as mercy. Mercy means that in all that we do, we are called to show love, to show compassion, to show grace. He also mentions humility. And humility is about understanding that none of us is any more or less loved by God than the other. What the prophet Micah says is simple in sound, but difficult in reality. But imagine for a moment what our country would look like, what it could be, if we all demanded those three things of ourselves: justice, kindness, humility. What does the Lord require of you? To do justice, to love kindness, to walk humbly with your God. In the gospel proclaimed from Luke, our Lord identifies some of the responsibility that comes with freedom. Let us listen again to what he says. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to captives, recovery of sight to the blind. Our Lord chose those words because they summed up his mission and ministry of sacrifice. His mission and ministry of offering his life as a gift for all. He has come to offer freedom. Freedom not to do as we want. Freedom not a life solely determined by individual and selfish preferences. But freedom to become fully alive. To be and become fully human. My friends, these words of our Lord are particularly appropriate for our gathering here today. Poverty might be about money or material need, such as food, clothing, or housing. But it's also about poverty of love, poverty of hope, poverty of meaning. The captive might be a prisoner, an addicted person, but it can also be a person suffering from a debilitating illness, a person overcome by anger and resentment.
Blindness is not only physical, but can also be emotional or spiritual. And the point is that wherever human life is impoverished, imprisoned, impaired, or restricted, we still have work to do. The work of democracy did not end on January 10, 1967. It began anew. Today, that work continues. The cause still endures. The vision still presses on. Wherever our youth are threatened, wherever our women are harassed or disrespected, wherever our elderly are forgotten, wherever our young men are overcome with a sense of hopelessness, we still have work to do. The challenges of today remind us that freedom is a way of life we will always have to struggle to preserve. To struggle to preserve as our forebears did. It should never be taken for granted. And so today, as we gather to observe Majority Rule Day, let us ask ourselves some questions. How can I match my talents, my gifts, with one of our nation's deepest needs? What can I do to ensure that our country lives up to its democratic ideals? What can I do to further our democracy, to safeguard the democratic principles many struggled and sacrificed greatly for? As we gather here today in this sacred place, let us lift up our country in prayer. May God bless us. May God bless our Bahama land.
Stand for the intercession. O God, we thank you for this day. We celebrate the ushering in of Majority Rule. We thank you for all the struggles, the sacrifices to make this possible and to bring about more justice in our country. May all persons, regardless of their common race or creed, be respected as full citizens of our nation. We pray for our Governor General, God, that you would guide and keep her in the administration of her duties. We pray for our Prime Minister, Hugh, that you would anoint him afresh with wisdom from on high, to guide his cabinet and this nation in a manner that will always inspire us to lift our heads to the rising sun. We pray for our members of Parliament and senators, those who serve this nation, that they would do it with diligence and integrity. We pray, dear God, for the judiciary, that justice and mercy be the hallmark of their decision. We remember now, O Lord, and pray for all who led the way for Majority Rule. And we thank you, Lord, for the work that is still being done to ensure equality for all. Our Lord, we pray for Bahamians everywhere, that you would keep us and guide us, that we would always be a nation whose God is the Lord, that where your name be praised, honored, and glorified. These and all other blessings we ask through Jesus Christ,
Amen.
The preceding was a broadcast of the Majority Rule Day Church Service held at St. Francis Xavier Cathedral, January 10th, 2018.